You know, looking out at this marvelous audience, do you know what I see? Do you? I see an ocean of heroes. I see you. I see you. You are all people on a mission, and you've chosen to work on some of the toughest questions, not just for Africa, but also for the world. So you are heroes, and you are my heroes. And today, what I'd like to talk about is what it means to lead a heroic life. But first and foremost, let me acknowledge how privileged all of us are to be alive today, at this moment in history, at a time of profound change in the world and in Africa, and how privileged we are, all of us, to be engaged in creating what I would like to call the African century. So if you just think, 60 years ago, some extraordinary leaders and extraordinary citizens across this continent ushered in a new era of independence. And this was followed by decades of nation building, a process not without its own challenges, but also a process which saw pivotal moments and triumphs, progress. And in the last decade, some of the fastest growing economies in the world have been African. And more recently, we've seen initiatives across this continent which have strengthened governance, infrastructure, telecommunications, transportation, energy. And soon, we will experience a single African market. I think it's safe to say that everyone here, especially all of the young people, you've grown up and you are growing up in a time when you have better access to education, to healthcare, to opportunities. Opportunities that were undreamt of by your parents and your grandparents. I am so fortunate to be able to travel across many countries on this continent. And everywhere I go, I have an opportunity to meet young entrepreneurs who are pursuing fresh ideas in business, in arts, in culture, in education, in healthcare, in climate change. Young people who have such a sense of pride, of ownership, and of possibility, all of which is palpable. And so I think we are blessed. We're blessed to be living in a time when this continent is coming into its own. And at a time when your talents, your vision, your leadership is so needed. And this is because we also face challenges. Challenges of climate change, hunger, conflict, poverty. And we face what has already been referred to earlier today. Perhaps the most defining challenge and the defining opportunity of our time. And that is the challenge of youth employment. Nigeria and 36 other countries on this continent are on track to double their population by 2030. So with each passing day, this amazing continent grows younger. And very soon, 100 million young people will enter the workforce. Now the question on their minds, that of their parents, and I would wager every single president, is what will they do? And how will they find meaningful work? So turning this challenge into an opportunity is the animating mission of the MasterCard Foundation's new strategy, a strategy which we call Young Africa Works. We've set out a bold target, as Femi mentioned a moment ago, to enable 30 million young people, especially young women, to find dignified and fulfilling work by 2030. Now, how will we reframe this challenge? And how will we restate it as an opportunity? What if we said Africa will be home to the world's workforce? Is that an opportunity? Is that an opportunity we can capitalize on? This requires transformation, not just only of economy, but transformation of how we all solve problems. And at the foundation, We think some of this, some of the answer, might lie in what we call making the invisible visible. It's very clear that countries are growing, economies are expanding, industries are being built. There is work and plenty of it to be done.
But these work opportunities are not always visible or accessible to young people. So much of what we must do is help young people recognize and capitalize
on the opportunities around them. This means equipping them and empowering them, not only just to find work or create work today, but to also create work in tomorrow's economy. It means breathing life into old industries and reinventing them in some ways, like agriculture, to be cleaner, greener, and part of the digital age. So how do we make the invisible visible? How do we bring something into the world that did not exist before? I think you know the answer, because all of you are actually creating answers, and that is through entrepreneurship. It's a mindset that sees problems as opportunities, and you're already doing this. When I think about some of the amazing ventures that LEAP fellows are spearheading, I already see them. You're making the invisible visible. Your ventures are making blood transfusions simpler, safer. You're helping others find work through your online platforms. You're using mobile devices to help patients find support for psychological trauma. And in the process, you're creating work for others. I'd like to call out one individual because I was so impressed by what I read. She's one of your own, a LEAP fellow, Chioma Ukonu, who is the co-founder of Recycle Points Nigeria. Is she here? Are you here? Will you stand up if you are here? I don't know if she's here, but I hope she can hear me through if this is being live streamed. Chioma and her partners recognize the health and environmental hazards with seeing waste pile up in their communities. And so they started small, but they've started a recycling revolution. Today, they have 28 employees running a range of programs and close to 10,000 subscribers using their platform to recycle or to divert 75 tons of waste each month. So Recycle Points Nigeria is a powerful example of transforming a problem into a solution, essentially turning trash into treasure. Now, as entrepreneurs, you know that within every challenge is an opportunity. In every gap, a startup. In every problem, a solution. But what does this have to do with leading a heroic life or being a hero? And I thought that the first place to start is with the definition, at least the definition that I looked at, which says that a hero is a person who is admired for his or her courage, outstanding achievements, or noble qualities. And in my book, a hero checks all three. Heroism isn't just a state of being, it's a choice. It's a choice we're called on to make every single day. And you've already made courageous decisions to solve very difficult problems. And in so doing, you've already chosen an unconventional path. We know that entrepreneurship can be a lonely journey. Our families may love us, but they may not always understand our passions. Our ideas may sound really crazy to our friends. Convincing investors and funders isn't always easy. Our business models require refinement constantly. And inevitably, there will be setbacks in execution. This can go on for a while, in some cases for years. And so sticking to your dreams, sticking to your own vision, requires discipline. It requires planning, resilience, grit. This is about personal staying power. And if we dig deeper into resilience, I usually find three drivers. Number one, it's about standing for something. And this means really understanding yourself, your principles, your values, the moral compass that guides your life. Second, this is about standing up for others. We know that this path is not about ego. It's not about ourselves. It's far greater than ourselves. It's about a burning desire to improve the human condition. And number three, it's about standing up for ideas. Ideas that may seem so counterintuitive, so out there. Bold ideas which actually drive you into entrepreneurship. Ideas that allow you to be inventive, creative, eternally curious. Because it is curiosity that enables innovation, and it is innovation that has enabled progress. So as you continue down this path, I hope you think about these three things: standing for something, standing up for others, and standing for bold ideas. And while you do, it's also important to recognize that as you move down the path, you can't do this work alone. And this is where community comes into the picture. Community gives us strength, helps us stay true to ourselves, but community doesn't build itself by itself. This takes intention. So wherever you go, build a community. Build it for yourself and build it for others. Seek mentors and become a mentor. Because in this process, your journey will not only be successful, it'll be joyful, it'll be happy. Because you live in community. And this is the beautiful spirit of Leap Africa. So whatever your dreams, whatever your vision, you can do it. You already are contributing to the African century. You are amazing. And don't forget that. Don't forget that, that you're amazing. So in closing, I don't want to wish you luck, because I know and I have a sense that you will create your own luck. Instead, I'd like to wish you joy in leading a heroic life. Thank you.